Client-centered therapy, also known as person-centered therapy, is non-directive form of talk therapy, allowing the client to take more of a lead in discussions so that in the process, they will discover their own solution. The founder of client-centered therapy is a psychologist namely Carl Rogers. He developed this therapy during 1940 to 1950. According to Carl Rogers, this newer approach differs from the older one in that it has a genuinely different goal. It aims directly toward the greater independence and integration of the individual rather than hoping such results will accrue if the therapist assists in solving the problem. The therapist acts as facilitator, focusing on the client's feelings in order to make the client comfortable while in therapy. The therapist supports and encourages the client without interfering the client's self-discovery process.
Client-centered therapy focuses on its key component, the self-concept. The self-concept is an organized configuration of perceptions of the self which are admissible to awareness. It is composed of perceptions of one's characteristics and abilities, perception of the self in relation to the environment, goals and ideals perceived as having positive and or negative valence. A disturbed person is one whose self-concept is developed selectively by accepting some experiences and denying others. Client-centered therapy is geared towards resolving the incongruence between the self-concept and the external experience. This approach implies that the subject matter of this therapy is the client's world of immediate experience or situation rather than his or her remote past. The focus is on the client's internal frame of reference. It is the therapist's function to assume that internal frame of reference of the client to perceive the world as the client sees it, to lay aside all the perceptions from the external frame of reference while doing so. How does person-centered therapy works? Carl Rogers believed that people have the power to find solutions to their own conflicts. The success of person-centered therapy relies on three core conditions.